Time for another quick DVD update. In my attempt to get caught up, I'm doing these as fast as possible, putting them out pretty quick. First one this time is a Joy Sales Fortune Star release, a new release, of Yes, Madam. And I was very excited to hear that they were putting this one out. This was one that was taken from me, and I've been trying to get it back. I had originally the Hong Kong disc, which wasn't that great, but it was alright. And I wanted to get the HKL, Hong Kong Legends, release. The only time I came across it on eBay, for example, was as part of a box set, Michelle Yeoh box set, and I didn't need the other two movies, and I wasn't going to pay that much for the one movie. I kept waiting and waiting and waiting, and finally they announced this. Newly remastered Yes, Madam. Great movie from Corey Ewan from the 80s, 1985. Starring Michelle Yeoh, also Cynthia Rothrock. Actually, the whole cast is going to be recognizable faces. I mean, you're going to know, if you're a Hong Kong fan, you're going to recognize just about everybody in it. Sammo Hung has a small part, for example. There's the back. The slip case. There's the disc. So there's Yes, Madam, one of the original Girls with Guns Hong Kong genre movies. I know a lot of people are really put off by the tone shifts in this movie. It goes from hard, violent action to weird comedy. I don't know, I like it. I think it's a good movie. I'm glad it came out. I'm thrilled to finally have it. There you go. Next one. This I got finally. I never had it before. I kept putting it off, and it sort of got hard to get for a little bit, but a little while ago, Mad Puppet Death did a VHS video. And she showed the VHS of it, and I thought, man, I really need to pick up that DVD. Gargoyles, They're Coming for You. TV movie from 1972, but that was back when TV movies were cool. You look back at the 70s and 80s, and they had some great TV movies. Killdozer, Satan's School for Girls, The Intruder Within, Gargoyles. Just great, great movies that... they don't even come close to that these days. PCI Entertainment. Fun movie with a good cast. Cornel Wilde in the lead. Jennifer Salt as his daughter. Bernie Casey as the main gargoyle. Scott Glenn as a biker who gets wrapped up in everything that's going on. Great makeup and outfits on the gargoyles thanks to Stan Winston and friends. Good stuff. So thanks, Lori. You inspired me to go after it finally. I'm glad I did. I don't know why I never did before. I've always liked the movie. I always wanted the DVD. I just never got around to it. So now I finally got around to it. Saturday Morning Cartoons, 1980s. As far as I'm concerned, a very cool set. I mean, I got it primarily to have some Thundar on DVD, but there's some fun stuff on here. Dragon's Lair. The Flintstones kids are on here. The Mr. T Show, where he's live action at the beginning and end. Chuck Norris and the Karate Commandos, he's live action at the beginning and end. And there's another show, very Thundar-like. Let me make sure I get the name right. Galtar and the Golden Lance. Two discs in the set. There's the first one. There's the second one. There's the backs. Even the Ed Grimley cartoon had a certain nostalgic happiness to it that I didn't mind watching. I would never buy more of it, of just that. If they put out a box set of that, I definitely wouldn't get it, but this was fun. It was just fun watching these. I had a blast. If you're into 80s cartoons, this kind of thing, Saturday morning cartoons, definitely check it out. Plus, you get some Thundar. Next one up is an Image release. It's out of print, but it's not impossible to get at all. It's called There's Nothing Out There. Rolf Kanefsky, his first film, actually. In a way, a spoof, in a way, a sci-fi horror camp-a-thon. That's the alien right there. It's got a character in it that's seen all the horror movies at the video store of his local town, so he knows what to look out for. He knows what's coming next. Nobody listens to him. Sound familiar? Well, started here. And as you can see, it's got a fair amount of extras. So, they did a good release. If you're a fan of this movie, it's definitely worth picking up. And there's the disc and the chapter insert. He's just going to town there. Pretty entertaining movie. Next movie is The Career Killer, known as Megaforce. Early 80s action sci-fi epic. Starring Barry Bostwick, Michael Beck from The Warriors, Henry Silva, Persis Kambada, a.k.a. the bald chick from Star Trek The Motion Picture. I don't know. I like it. What can I say? I like it a lot. I even played the Atari game back in the day. That's right, I was rocking in the desert. It's from Dutch Filmworks. Oddly enough, you can see the Fortune Star logo there. That surprised me a little bit. It says 4:3 full frame, but it's actually letterboxed, just not anamorphic. And there's the highly reflective disc. I really wouldn't know where to begin to describe this to somebody who hasn't seen it. I recommend looking it up here on YouTube. I'm sure there's trailers, clips, a lot of Henry Silva stuff probably. But take a look. You never know. You might like it. You might not. I wouldn't go out of my way to recommend it to anybody, but I like it, so I had to pick up the disc. Last one for this time is a Switchblade Pictures double feature of Birthday Mail and Kokori-san. To be honest, it was more interesting than I thought it was going to be. They both were. Birthday Mail and Kokori-san both have very familiar storylines if you watch a lot of Asian horror films. Birthday Mail is, well, people get texts on their cell phones 10 days from their birthday saying, congratulations, it's 10 days till your last birthday. There's a ghost, there's something else going on. It's kind of familiar, but I liked it. I liked the way they did it. Kokori-san it's a Ouija board horror movie. Haunted house, contacting evil spirits. But I also like that one, even though it's far from the most original stuff you're ever going to see. There's the back. As you can see at the bottom, it's 126 minutes total. So they're both about an hour long. Ghost schools and grisly consequences galore. There's the disc. Entertaining for me. If you're a Switchblade fan, you're safe. Definitely pick it up. It's worth it. It'll fit into the Switchblade collection nicely. As always, guys, thanks for watching. I appreciate it. Later.